What is my take on Philip Salvador? Sabi ni Marield Pahar. Okay, ganito yon. I believe in party politics. I believe that if we're going to support a party, we support everybody in that party. Kasi baka may makalusot na kalaban. That being said, I think that Philip Salvador is a weak candidate. Weak in mind, I mean intellect, sorry, and weak in following. I mean, kailan ba yung last na pelikula niya? Normally, as a matter of strategy, may mga political parties talaga na nagsasama ng artista. O kaya nagsasama ng super yaman na negosyante. These are strategic. Alam niyo na kung bakit. Panghatak ng boto, panghatak ng pondo. But, in this case, in the case of Philip Salvador, I see no advantage for the party na nandyan siya. At ang dinig ko ay mayroong isang kandidato din na nagpasok sa kanya dahil works niya. I think that this is the worst kind of ano of what? Nepotism ba ang tawag doon? Na ipapasok mo kaibigan mo sa senatorial lineup and for what? Para maano? Para maubos ang pera ng PDP. PDP cannot afford a whole lot of candidates. So they should be supporting strong candidates that have, you know, the intellectual backing for that. Bakit intellect? Kasi makikipagbardagulan ka. You will be arguing. You will be telling the people, vote for me because ganito. Because I know better. Itong kabilang kandidato, sabi ganito. Tapos pwede natin pagtawanan, diba? So, for me, he's a weak candidate and does not deserve the endorsement of the PDP. Alright, so let's talk about Miss Gloria. Okay, she just retired from government service, but she retired in the DepEd. In other words, pinagbigyan siya. She was being asked to resign. O sabi niya, hindi, magre-retire na lang ako. May mga findings about her. May mga findings that she could have been dismissed for cause. Pero she was allowed to retire. She had been with the DepEd only about 22 months. But she was giving the impression, no, na parang ang tagal-tagal na niya doon. But she has continuous service in the government for ilang years. I'm not sure how many years. So inallow naman siya to retire. Binigyan pa nga siya ng send-off ng DepEd. But, kaya nga hindi sure kung bakit after all that, may hinanakit pa rin siya. Take note that with her retirement, she was given her full benefits. In other words, despite the fact na mayroong findings sa kanya, and these findings are on record, inalaw siya ng Department of Education under VP Sara to retire with her benefits. Now, she received 9 envelopes supposedly containing money. And what she says that she never opened it, but later on that she did. And then, medyo nagbago yung story niya. She didn't open them, but when she saw that it was cash, she donated it supposedly to an NGO, which she did not name. Now, her evidence are the alleged nine envelopes. Thank you, kay Jevin. Ano ang evidentiary value ng envelopes na yon? It's not much. Alam niyo kung bakit? Kasi if it were a court, kasi nga, Congress is intent on making themselves look like they're a court at nagde-decide sila or nagdidinig sila ng isang kasong kriminal. Pero, hindi naman sila marunong mag-appreciate ng ebidensya. Kahit mismo si Congresswoman Lumistro, who is a lawyer and appears to have extensive litigation experience, does not only mentions yung envelopes but primarily concentrates on the victimization of Ms. Mercado. Binigay niya yung envelopes, tapos may handwritten doon na parang for the Hope or something like that. Hope is head of procurement entity. So, ang ibig sabihin niyan is, parang pinalalabas niya na these envelopes contained money and they were addressed to her and therefore binigyan siya. Is it evidence, regardless of whether it was cash or even a check. Kung cheque kasi yun, it will be easy enough that may paper trail yan. Kung cheque yan, there will be a canceled check somewhere. Or there's evidence na in-encash niya yung cheque na yun. Or if she deposited it, mayroon pong ano, makikita yung deposit na yun. So doon sa ano, if indeed she donated it to an NGO, that NGO will have a receipt, will issue a receipt for having received the check.
After watching this video, mag-comment lang, dahil ang iyong boses at paniniwala ay mahalaga para maimulat ang katotohanan. Ito ay para sa bayan.
And then they will also show that the check had been deposited in their account. Ang evidence lang niya, she did not name the NGO. But the only evidence she had was supposedly the envelopes that either contained cash or a check. Ako, I'm more inclined to think that it would be a cash. Why? If she's implying that this was a crime or there could have been a crime here, then why would anybody leave a paper trail? Bakit magbibigay sila ng cheque? Diba? Ang tanga, sorry, ang clueless talaga kasi I'm seeing the naysayers here and they're saying, di cheque yun. Ay, cheque. That would have been an incredibly uninformed, ignorant attempt to bribe. Diba? Kung yan po ay bribe nga, tapos cheque ang ginamit mo, ano yun, may death wish ka? Ano yun, mayroon kang flag saying, yuhu, look at me, I'm trying to bribe this person. Diba? Kaloka. So, it appears that the quality of the people they are sending to us is desperately low.